as the saying goes, the only guarantees in life are death and taxes. Well, I want to add one more thing to that list, and that's cataracts. Surprisingly, there are many different types of cataracts that people can get. Some you can get at a younger age. One of those types of cataracts is called a Christmas tree cataract, and yes, that's actually a real thing. So in this video, we're going to talk about the different types of cataracts and why you get them. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. EyeGuy, with a show that focuses on keeping your eyes healthy and your vision clear. I do a lot of educational videos just like this one, so make sure you subscribe for any future videos, and also make sure you hit that bell so you don't miss any videos that come out. Now, let's talk about cataracts. Cataracts is one of the most common conditions that eye doctors deal with. In fact, cataract surgery is one of the most common surgeries done in America. Most people that live long enough will get a cataract. I'm gonna first go over the more common types of cataracts that we see in the clinic that most people will get if they live long enough, and then stay towards the end of the video, I'll go over the more unique types of cataracts like snowflake cataracts or the rare cataract, a Christmas tree cataract. It's real. Now, just a quick summary on cataracts and where they are located. Cataracts happens in the crystalline lens. The crystalline lens is right behind, posterior to the iris, or the color part of your eye. This crystalline lens is actually what is responsible for focusing light, meaning transitioning from distance to near. That's what allows you to transition your focus. This lens is clear, so light can pass through it and be focused on the back of the retina. Now, unfortunately, over time, this lens becomes harder, more cloudy, thicker, and eventually kind of is classified as having a cataract or a cloudy or hazy portion of that lens. Definitely the most common type of cataract that we see in the clinic is called a nuclear sclerotic cataract. This cataract or opacification happens usually in the center of the lens or the nucleus, and usually what happens is that center nucleus will opacify over time. It will actually kind of turn a yellow color or brunescence. And when this happens, people usually have symptoms of decreased contrast. They have more glare symptoms, especially when they're driving at nighttime. They usually feel like they need more light to read print, so they'll get extra light to read print on a book, mainly because that contrast is down. Now, one interesting symptom that people can get when they get this type of cataract is they'll have what's called a myopic shift, or their eyes will actually become more nearsighted. Now, it's kind of coined the term a second sight, because sometimes people start off farsighted and they'll drift towards being nearsighted as that cataract gets worse, and it will feel like that their vision is actually improving over time. So sometimes patients will all of a sudden be flabbergasted and excited because their vision actually starts to improve because of that myopic shift, just depending on where your original prescription started. But some people have the benefit of this myopic shift, at least for a while, until the cataract actually gets dense and will start to decrease their visual acuity or decrease their vision to the point where they need cataract surgery to get that cataract out. Now, the second most common type of cataract that we see is called a coritcal cataract. And this cataract usually starts on the outside edges of the crystalline lens and actually looks like little bicycle spokes or wheel spokes that start from the outside edge and go towards the center of the lens. And when we look at people's eyes, at patients' eyes, we can actually see little spokes kind of sneaking in towards the center of the lens. And the closer these little spokes, these little opacifications get to the center of the lens, that's when people start having symptoms or it starts causing decreased vision, glare problems, and becomes annoying. And these little spokes or these little cortical cataracts usually have a white or a hazy appearance. Sometimes it could be a darker appearance as well. But yeah, comes from the sides entering to the center, kind of like little fingers. Now, the third most common type of cataract that we see are called subcapsular cataracts. There's an anterior subcapsular cataract, and probably the most common one is a posterior subcapsular cataract. Now, this crystalline lens actually sits in a bag in your eye. It's called the capsular bag, or the capsule And this cataract, the subcapsular cataract, forms right underneath that bag. And it almost forms like a little blanket that spreads across that bag or across that lens. Now, what's interesting, the first two types of cataracts that I mentioned, the nuclear cataract and the cortical cataracts, they're usually age-related, meaning the older people get, the more likely they're gonna get these types of cataracts. Now, this type of cataract, the subcapsular cataract, can also be age-related, but the posterior subcapsular cataract is also linked to people that have had steroid use, corticosteroids, or diabetes with high blood sugar levels can form this posterior subcapsular cataract. Now, what kind of stinks is that posterior subcapsular cataract, like I said, forms a blanket right on the back of that lens, and it's just a horrible spot because a lot of times it does form near the center, the central visual axis, and can actually decrease the patient's vision quite a bit and can be drastic or can happen really quick. They're very hard to predict on how fast this type of cataract will spread. I've seen some patients where they'll just have the little beginnings of a subcapsular cataract, and all of a sudden, 6 months later, they're needing cataract surgery because it spread just enough to cover their central visual axis and completely devastated their vision. Now, another type of cataract to be aware of is something called a traumatic cataract, meaning if you have trauma to the eye, you can develop a cataract in your lens. And this can be blunt trauma, meaning if you're punched in the eye or you get hit in the eye, can cause a cataract down the road, a traumatic cataract. And they do have a specific appearance. In fact, sometimes they're called a rosette cataract. They're almost sometimes shaped like a rose, or they'll have this flower appearance, or there'll just be a certain section or a certain wedge of the lens that has this cataract in it. Now, another kind of interesting type of cataract is something called vacuoles. They usually look like little tiny bubbles that have formed inside the crystalline lens. Now, the good thing about these vacuoles is usually the patients are asymptomatic. It doesn't really cause any problems with their vision or glare, unless you have a ton of them, but usually they're kind of sporadic and spread out. Sometimes they can form into a more centralized location, but usually and luckily this type of cataract really doesn't cause that many problems. Now, like I said before, cataracts can be present even in youngsters. In fact, there are congenital or infantile cataracts, and usually the most common type of presentation of this type of cataract is an opacification that kind of surrounds the embryonic nucleus of that crystalline lens. Now, what's tricky is sometimes this cataract doesn't really affect the vision of the child, but it can. And so what's tricky is determining is if the cataract is visually significant that's gonna delay the development of that eye. And so it's hard to determine if that eye will need cataract surgery to get that opacification out there. And then what's tricky on top of that is if you do the cataract surgery, it's pretty common that that child may develop glaucoma down the road in that eye that had the cataract surgery in there. And on top of that is when they take that lens out, they don't want to put a new lens in there because they're still growing. And so a lot of times that child, baby, infant, toddler needs to wear a contact lens, usually a hard contact lens, to help develop that eye so that eye can see. So that type of cataract can be a little complicated. Hey, and before I get to the more unique types of cataracts, just take a second and comment below if you yourself have dealt with a cataract, or if you have any questions about cataracts, and also leave a like if you've found value from this video. Now, one unique type of cataract is actually called a snowflake cataract. Now, the patients that usually get this type of cataract are usually really sensitive and overly offended, and they'll get this cataract. I'm just kidding. It's not that type of snowflake cataract. Let me explain. So snowflake cataracts are actually found in diabetics. It's sometimes called a diabetic cataract. And even young patients, even 30 years old, can actually get this type of cataract depending on how their diabetes is. Now, if your blood sugar is out of control, usually what happens is you'll get glucose that actually gets into the crystalline lens, and this glucose is converted to sorbitol. Now, sorbitol almost acts like a sponge. It actually sucks in water and creates a high water content within that lens, so it turns the lens into a sponge. Now, if you can imagine, if that crystalline lens is a sponge and it soaks up water, it actually gets thicker and change shape, And this will also cause a shift in vision. It can be a myopic shift, usually if your glucose levels or blood sugar levels are really high. And so a lot of times in diabetics that don't have their blood sugar under control may experience changes in vision. It's because of that lens changing shape. Now this process of glucose getting into the edges of the crystalline lens will actually cause these little white snowflake opacifications on the outside of that lens, and that's why they call it a snowflake cataract. Now, one of the more rare types of cataracts is called a Christmas tree cataract. Now, the reason why they call it a Christmas tree cataract is because it actually looks like a Christmas tree. Now, this type of cataract can actually produce little colorful opacifications inside the lens. It's usually deep cortex or the nucleus of the lens. Now these little opacities can look like little red, green, or gold little sparkles, and there also can be purple that kind of looks like little Christmas tinsel draped across the Christmas tree. Now this type of cataract is obviously not as common. It can be age-related, but usually it's more commonly found in people with myotonic dystrophy. Myotonic dystrophy is a progressive muscle weakness disease, and this cataract can actually occur at any age. Now, there are many other different types of cataracts out there. Cataracts can be caused by a number of different things: systemic conditions, different diseases, genetic disorders, medications can cause certain types of cataracts, age-related, obviously. So this just hits home that it's really important that you go in for your regular eye exams with your eye doctor so they can actually look at the health of the eye, check your lens out. Even if your vision is great, you feel like you see great, you have 20/20 vision, one of the most important things of an eye exam is to make sure your eyes are healthy, and this is one of the many things that we check when we're doing a comprehensive eye exam. And as always, thanks for watching. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, looking out for you and your eyes. Stay focused, and I'll see you in the next video.